The Satanic Temple is now officially an IRS-approved tax-exempt church in Salem, Massachusetts.
This is good news. Okay, go on.
Yeah. So, the Satanic Temple is now an official temple, according to them, the IRS. The interest reserve, what is the IRS again? I'm not
International Revenue Agency, I think.
Oh, yeah.
I just came up with that. I don't know. Maybe. Go on. No, IRS stands for... Hey, the tax people in the United States. Go on. Right.
Yeah. It has recognized the group as a tax-exempt religious organization. Temple co-founder Lucian Greaves added that there was nothing hypocritical about a group that fights religion applying for a religious tax exemption.
Okay. Finish it fast, and I'll...
In fact, he was motivated to seek the exemption specifically after Donald Trump signed an executive order telling the Treasury Department not to go after religious institutions.
So, you're saying is that people are... Okay, so a lot of people don't understand that the Satanic Temple in the United States is not a religious organization. That sounds counterintuitive, but it's not. It's actually an anti-religion organization, which is using satanic symbols and ideology as a way to fight any threats to secularism, right? So the people in the Satanic Temple are atheists, right? Yeah. The people, they're not Satan worshippers. They don't believe in the devil. They're atheists. They have built this temple as a way to for whenever the Christians try bring religion to politics, whenever they bring religion to school, whenever they bring religion to taxpayer funded public areas, whenever religion gets a special privilege, like the church is being tax exempt. Because they know Christians are so scared of anything satanic, they're like, well, if you're opening the door to religion here, then you should also let our temple, the Satanic Temple, as well. And this has worked so perfectly when, for example, when they brought Bibles to school, and the Freedom From Religion Foundation, I think, couldn't, like, when other organizations tried to stop it and they couldn't, now religion was allowed in school. Then the Satanic Temple showed up, like, okay, we have satanic coloring book for children now in public schools. And the parents lost their mind and were like, okay, fine, no religion in school, right?
Yeah.
And whenever they had, like, the Ten Commandments in the, you know, in the city hall or in courthouses or in city hall, and the Freedom From Religion Foundation tried to take it out and they couldn't, then the Satanic Temple, like, okay, we're going to have a statue right there in the middle as well. And so basically the Christians are learning that if they want to open the door to religion, they have to open it to all religions. And they're scared of... And the thing is that there's two ways to make them regret opening the door to religion. One of them is when Muslims also are like, open the door to religion, so Islam as well. But I don't like that because I don't want Islam. Like, I prefer the Satanic Temple. They're also they're terrified of Islam, but they're also terrified of the Satanic Temple. But because the Satanic Temple is run by atheists and it's just meant to scare the shit out of Christians, I prefer them being used as a way to regret opening the door to religion rather than the Muslims.
Yes,
right?
Because sometimes, in some cases, concessions are made to Islam, so they get the same privileges as Christians. That's not what we want.
Yeah, that's not what we don't want. The Christians to regret the decision because now we have Islam getting special privileges as well. We want them to regret their decisions because the Satanic Temple is there now, and this is great. So some people that know that this is the nature of the Satanic Temple is not a religious organization, it's meant to be anti-religion. Now they're going to the Satanic Temple and like, what the fuck? Now you're a tax-exempt church. You're supposed to be an anti-religion organization, but I don't think I know they. But this is exactly how they fight anti-religion, because they say, why churches get tax-exempt? If Christian churches get tax-exempt, then the Satanic Temple should also get tax-exempt, right? So now, congratulations, Christians in the United States. Now you have Satanic Temples that is financially supported by your governments. this is your doing. You have to live with it. I love this. I love the fact that they got this tax exemption status. You know, they have to see if they don't like secularism, they have to know that the real consequences of not having secularism is not the triumph of Christianity. The real consequences of not having secularism is triumph of every fucking religion, especially the ones that you don't like. So you have to live with it. It's secularism or the satanic fucking temple, motherfuckers. Like, this is what you get if you don't have secularism. So I love this.
By the way, can I ask your opinion about Pastafarianism?
So I liked Pastafarianism because that's also intended to do this, but that's too obvious of a joke, right? So if you get Pastafarianism into, like, you get tax exemption from, you know, or if you get them, if you have a giant spaghetti monster, something somewhere in the public, or in a city hall or somewhere, Christians are like, well, whatever, what the fuck, these people are idiots, they believe in a giant spaghetti monster. Like, okay, fine, have that there. It just looks like a spaghetti monster. They're not offended by that. I want them to be offended, okay? The satanic temple, this is something real to them. This is like the fucking devil being endorsed by the government, right? So both the Satanic Temple and the Pastafarian, I mean, I'm an ordained minister by the Pastafarian Church. So I might be biased to say, like, yeah, Pastafarianism should be used the same way, but it doesn't have the same impact. So there's three. You have the opening the door to religion. You could either use Islam or Pastafarianism or the Satanic Temple to make them regret not having secularism. But the problem is that Islam shouldn't work because we don't want Islam to get privileges. Pastafarianism doesn't work because Pastafarianism coming into public life doesn't make them regret anything because they're not that offended by it, or they don't see it as something to be scared of. But the Satanic Temple is both an atheist supported organization, is not meant to be a religion, and it also something that offends them. So it's the perfect combination, I think. That's why I support them over.
Maybe. Yeah. Can I just have a short digression on Pastafarianism? Yeah. Because there is a case in the Netherlands right now, and it went to the Council of State, which is the highest court in the Netherlands, right, when a Pastafarian woman said she wanted to wear a colander picture on a driving license,
right,
and she was rejected because even though the Church of the Flying Spaghetti Monster is a registered church association in the Netherlands, it's not recognized as a religion, and the Council of State said it's not a religion because it lacks coherence.
What? So, okay. What? So
coherence is now a criterion to be a religion now.
That's good, but that's great because now we can say now we can go like, okay, so all their religions, if we can show lack of coherence in Islam and Christianity, then they should also lose all their privileges. That's great. Exactly. Precedent.
This is very interesting precedent. So yeah. I think so this Pastafarian woman is now going to take this to the European court. So
that's great. We should cover that when this happens.
Yeah, so, yeah, okay. And it's important precedent because religion as such has never been given a legal definition, and by these precedents, we may eventually force lawyers to or judges to make a judgment on what a religion is. What's the definition, a legal definition of a religion?
Right.
Once we've got that, we can say, well, so this and this and this religion says that and that and that, and then see how well this fits.
It's going to be impossible to draw the line. So
this is actually very interesting, and it's Pastafarianism doing this, so I'm very curious what will happen next.
Atheists are under attack in many places. If they were Christians, their voices would be heard. If they were Jews, their voices would be heard. If they were Muslims, their voices would be heard. But they are atheists, and not many seem to be listening. Let's make it difficult for them to ignore us. We have built a global community, and now we are tearing down geographic, cultural, and language barriers so we can find each other and support each other. In the last decade, we have built the largest atheist community in the world. Now we are doing the same in other languages. With your help, we have started Atheist Republic in Persian and Arabic.
انضميت مؤخرا لأسرة Atheist Republic وحيصير عندي بودكاست باللغة العربية.
As we grow, we can dedicate more time, staff, and resources to start doing the same in Spanish, Portuguese, Malay, Bengali, Urdu, Hindi, and other languages. We are providing community, support, informative content, and amplifying the voices of those who need protection, especially in countries where people feel isolated simply for their lack of belief. We want to be there for them, and we are only getting started. Help us get there. Check in the description for ways you can support our projects.